The colon can be classified into two types, short colon and slender colon. The short colons normally have a small cross-sectional area relative to its effective length. As for the slender colon, the cross-sectional area is relatively small in comparison to its effective span. A short colon is less likely to undergo buckling, while slender columns normally undergo buckling. Therefore, the effects of P delta will be small for the short colon, while it is large for slender column. A short column normally fails by crushing, while the slender column normally fails by buckling. The buckling response normally will degrade the resistance of the column under axial load. To determine the column whether it is short or slender, we need to determine its slenderness ratio. The slenderness ratio is to be compared with the slenderness limit. And when the slenderness ratio is less than the limit, the member is considered as a short column. While it is equals or larger than the limit, a slender column is identified.